Hello students, welcome to this online lecture of computer science. Today we are going to start with the paper number 1, chapter 4, Visual Basic. Basically, what does Visual Basic mean? Visual Basic is an event-driven programming language and environment from Microsoft that provides a graphical user interface, which allows programmers to modify code by simply dragging and dropping objects and defining their behavior and appearance. VB is derived from the basic programming language and is considered to be event-driven and object-oriented. VB is intended to be easy to learn and fast to write code with. As a result, it is sometimes called a rapid application development and is used to prototype an application that will later be written in a more difficult but efficient language. So, this chapter introduces Visual Basics, that is VB's Integrated Development Environment, that is IDE, and the basic principle of developing applications with visual tools and event programming. We will study the steps of creating a simple application, that is math calculations, and the component of the visual development environment. We will take a tour of the environment and discuss the basics of developing user interface. After completing this chapter, one can write a program in VB with few lines. So, we assume that you have already decoded Visual Basic edition of VB. So, Visual Basic comes in three editions. The first edition, it is the Visual Basic Learning Edition. The second edition, it is the Visual Basic Professional Edition. And the last, that is the third, it is the Visual Basic Enterprise Edition. We will see these editions one by one. The first, it is the Visual Basic Learning Edition. So, it is the introductory edition that lets you easily create Windows applications. It covers with all the tools you need to build mainstream Windows applications. The second, it is the Visual Basic Professional Edition. So, it is for the computer professional and includes advanced features such as tools to develop ActiveX and Internet Control. So, in this chapter, we are going to see the basic type, that is the Visual Basic Learning Edition. And the third, it is the Visual Basic Visual Basic Enterprise Edition. It is the advanced edition and is assigned at programmers who build distributed applications in a team environment. It includes all the features of the professional edition plus tools such as Visual Source Safe, a version control system, and the automation and component manager. Depending on which edition of Visual Basic we are going to study, you may see fewer or more options in the menus and toolbars of the Visual Basic. VB is not just a language, it is an integrated development environment in which you can develop, run, test, and debug your application. Now, we will see the following type of application which are created using Visual Basic. The first, it is the standard EXE. So, it is a typical application. The second, it is the ActiveX EXE. ActiveX, DLL. These type of projects are available with the professional edition. ActiveX components are OLE automation services. So, OLE stands for Object Linking and Embedding. OLE, it is a Microsoft technology that facilitates the sharing of application, data and objects written in different formats from multiple sources. Linking establishes the connection between two objects and embedding application data insertion. The third application, it is the ActiveX control. So, an ActiveX control such as a text box or a command button control is a basic element of the user interface. You can build your own custom controls. The fourth, it is the ActiveX document EXE. ActiveX document DLL. ActiveX documents are VB application that run in the environment of a container that supports hyperlinking, such as Internet Explorer. The fifth type, it is the VB application wizard, VB wizard manager. The application wizard takes you through the steps of setting up the skeleton of a new application. The wizard manager lets you build your own wizard. A wizard is a sequence of windows that collect information from the user. The last application, it is the add-in. You can create your own add-ins for the VB IDE. Add-ins are special commands you can add to VB's menu. They appear under the add-ins menu. This is a Visual Basic project screen. So, there are various options in this screen. So, the first, it is the menu bar, toolbar. You can see here menu bar, toolbox, form, project container window, Project Explorer window, Properties window, Description pane, Form layout window. So this is the basic screen of project of the Visual Basic. Now we will see the basic menus. So the menu bar, it contains File, Edit, View, Project, Format, Debug, Run, Query, Diagram, Tools, Add-ins, Window, Help options. We will see these options one by one. The first option, that is the file. So it contains commands for opening and saving project and creating executable files and a list of recent projects. The second option, it is the edit. So, it contains editing commands, example, undo, copy, paste, find, replace. The third option in the menu bar, it is the view. So, it contains commands for showing or hiding components of the IDE. The next, it is the project. So, it contains commands that add components to the current project. The next option in the menu bar, it is the format. So, contains commands for aligning the controls on the form. The next menu, it is the debug. So, debugging, it contains usual debugging commands. The next menu, it is the run. It is used to start, break and end execution of the current application. The next, it is the query. Available when building database applications. The next menu, it is the diagram. So it is used when it is available when building database application used for editing database diagrams. The next command, it is the tools. So it contains tools. Those are needed in building ActiveX components and ActiveX control. Add-ins, command to add and remove add-ins. The next option, it is the windows. So it contains commands to arrange windows on the screen. The next option, it is the help. It contains information to help you as you work. So this is the diagram, basic diagram of the project, screen of the Visual Basic. Now we will see the next menu, that is the toolbox and the property editor. So here it is the toolbox. First of all, we will see the Project Explorer. So basically, the Project Explorer displays the components of the project. Simple projects are made up of single form. The project window is called Project Explorer because it has the look of Window Explorer. Now we will start with the toolbox. So toolbox and property editor. The first, it is the toolbox. It contains the icons of the control you can place on a form to create the application's user interface. To place a control on a form, you first select it with the mouse and then move the mouse over the form. The cursor turns into a cross and you can draw the control on the form. In addition to the default toolbox, you can create custom layouts by right-clicking the toolbox and selecting Add tab from the shortened menu. The next option, it is the properties window. So it contains the property settings for the selected control. Properties are attributes of an object such as its size, caption, and color. For example, caption property for a command button, black color property of form appearance. The third, it is the former designer. So it is the main window in the middle of the screen, and in it you can design and edit the application's user interface. The same window display text editors in which you can enter and edit the application's code. The form designer displays two windows for each form. The first, it is the form itself, and the second, it is a code window. The next option, it is the form layout. You can use the form layout window in the lower right corner of the VB IDE to determine the initial positions of the forms in your application. This window is useful in applications that use multiple forms. You can specify how each form is positioned with respect to the main form. And the last, it is the immediate window. So at the bottom of the IDE is debugging aid. Debugging means execution of the program. You can step into the application code while it executes, changes the values of the variable, or even insert statements in the code and then continue the execution of an application. So this is the diagram of the elements of the user interface use of controls. It is the diagram of layout of toolbox. So this is the toolbox, and the diagram of toolbox is There are various options in the toolbox: the picture box, text box, command button, option button, list box, vertical scroll bar, drive list box, file list box, data line, pointer, label, frame, checkbox, combo box, horizontal scroll, timer, directory list box, shape, image, OLE. Now let's see all these elements one by one. The first element of the user interface, use of control, it is a picture box. We will now see the function of this picture box. So this control is used to display images, and the images are set with the picture property. The second, it is the label. Label, it is here, the second option at the left side, second option. So this control displays text on a form that the user can't edit. Set the labels text with the caption property. The third, it is the text box. You can see at the right side, the second option, there is text box. So it displays the text that the user can edit. It is a mini text editor. Text property can set the text or read the text that the user enters. The next option, it is a frame. So at the left hand side, the third option, you can see that there is one option named as frame. So it is used to draw boxes on the form and to group other elements. The fifth option, it is the command button. At right hand side, the third option, you can see that it is the command button. So it represents an action that is carried out when the user clicks on the button. The sixth, it is the checkbox. At the left hand side, there is the fourth option, checkbox. The function of this checkbox, it presents one or more choices that the user can select. Main property is value, and it is 0 if the checkbox is cleared and 1 if the checkbox is checked. The seventh, it is the option button. At the right hand side, there is the fourth, that is the option button. The function of the option button, it's appear in groups and the user can choose only one of them. Main property is checked and it is true if the control is checked and false otherwise. The next, it is the combo box. So the combo box at the left hand side, you can see that there is a combo box. So the function of this, it is the similar to the list box control, but it contains text edit field. The user can enter, choose an item from the list and enter a new string in the edit field. The next, it is the list box. You can see at the right side, there is one option named as list box. The function of the list box is it contains a list of options from which the user can select one or more. The user can scroll the list to locate an item. The next option, it is a horizontal and vertical scroll bar. So you can see here, there is a horizontal scroll bar and the vertical scroll bar. Basically, it lets the user specify a magnitude by scrolling the controls button between its minimum and maximum value. The next, it is the timer. You can see here, there is a timer. So the function of the timer, it is to perform task at regular intervals. Main property is interval, which determines how often the timer notifies your application. The next option, it is the shape. It is used to draw graphical elements. The next option, it is the line. So Similar to shape control, the line control is used to draw lines on the form. You can see at the left hand side there is one option from the third last option, that is the shape. We use this for drawing the graphical elements, and the next was the line. So line, it is the shape control. It is used to draw lines on the form. The next, it is the images and data. Now we will see what does this image and data mean. So images, similar to the picture box control in that it can display images but supports few features of the picture box control. And the function of the data, it is provides point and click access to data stored in databases. The next, it is the OLE. So OLE, that is object linking and embedding. So this is a window you can place on your form to host documents from the other applications such as MS Word or Excel. And the next, it is the property setting. The properties window shows the property setting menus like caption, control box, font as shown in this figure. With this setting we can arrange the appearance of the control on the form. Here you can see that there is a properties window. Okay, so from this setting you can arrange the appearance of the control box. So in exams, question will be asked that explain the use of properties window, explain the use of controls in VB, that is text box, command button, combo box, frame, or state the features of Visual Basic. The next part of this chapter we will see in the next lecture.